First of all, a big thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Secondly, I love making these videos for you, but I need your support. All you have to do is click that subscribe button. It takes 2 seconds and it means the world to me. All right, here's today's video. Today I'm going to talk about reasons not to buy the 2019 Acura ILX, but I will be talking about reasons why you should buy one as well as how it stacks up against the competition. Let's begin with some of the cons. It may not be big enough for some families. If your family is of average size, they should fit in just fine on the inside of the ILX. On the other hand, tall families, basketball teams, volleyball players, will likely desire more space for their legs. Headroom is definitely not one of the ILX's strong points. Before you make a regrettable decision, bring your family with you to test drive it and to see how it fits your entire family. Another reason not to buy it, a so-so ride quality. Unfortunately, the ILX does not deliver the smoothest ride. When encountering bumpy road surfaces, expect to feel some roughness. Your passengers, maybe your family, may bounce around a bit. You'll notice the ILX rides more like a regular compact car opposed to a premium luxury sedan. It actually shares its platform with a previous generation Honda Civic. The A-Spec, which you see here, looks sportier than it really is. A lot of buyers will be interested in this A-Spec model. While the A-Spec model has a more aggressive look, it certainly does, it does not drive like a sport sedan. Aside from the upgraded tires, the A-Spec does not benefit from any other performance enhancements. Furthermore, you can't get the sedan with a manual gearbox. It's essentially a sheep in wolf's clothing. Acura does not offer the ILX with an all-wheel drive system. That could be a turnoff for you. It could turn away a lot of drivers who regularly experience snowfall during the winter. The BMW 3 Series with all-wheel drive might be a better choice. You may not like the twin-screen infotainment screen. While the ILX's infotainment screen has been updated, some drivers still may not like that twin-screen setup. A single screen would be less of a distraction, don't you think? The best approach is to try out systems beforehand to see what you like. On the positive side, here's some of the pros. The 2019 ILX allows you to ride in luxury without depleting your bank account. Prices start just shy of 26 grand. That means the new ILX is actually a couple of $1,000 less expensive than last year's model. How about that? Even the top trim level is priced below 30 grand. Some of the standard features include internet streaming radio, smart entry, and heated front seats. You'll also benefit from ILX's low cost of maintenance, which is far lower than the typical luxury car. You don't want to underestimate the vehicle's 2.4-liter four-cylinder engine. Over the years, the Honda-built engine has become known for its lively character. It kicks out 201 horses, 180 pound-feet of torque. Although it's a step slower than some competitors, it does not feel sluggish. When accelerating, the engine's sporty sound helps create a sense of driving excitement. In terms of fuel economy, a combined 29 miles per gallon in premium gas. It is sporty enough for you to have some fun in it. It's not designed, of course, to go head-to-head with a pure sports sedan. Nevertheless, it's definitely not a boring car to drive. Drivers will enjoy its rather quick steering. You'll also like how secure it feels on twisty roads. Although a traditional manual gearbox is no longer offered, paddle shifters allow you to control the gear shifts. A larger set of 18-inch performance tires are found on the upper trims. And here's something good. You no longer have to pay extra for the AccuWatch safety package. It's now included in the sedan's list of standard equipment. While the collision mitigation braking system anticipates crashes, road departure mitigation prevents you from accidentally veering off the pavement, adaptive cruise control and lane keep assist are included as well. While blind spot monitoring is offered, you must step up to a higher trim for that. It also has good crash protection and solid brakes. It does a great job of shielding passengers during an accident. It received a National Highway Traffic Safety Administration's top overall rating for impact protection. Front crash prevention is considered to be superior by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety, so every family will be able to travel with an additional peace of mind. You'll also benefit from the ILX's responsive brakes, which performed well during paddock tests. As mentioned before, the dual-screen infotainment system isn't a big fan favorite. However, Acura has tweaked it to be more responsive to your touch. Graphics are sharper. Smartphone users will especially like the fact that Apple CarPlay and Android Auto were added this year. So how does it stack up against the competition? Although the 2019 Mercedes-Benz CLA is more expensive, it does have a few disadvantages over the ILX. The CLA's turbocharged engine gives you a stronger kick under the hood. Furthermore, all-wheel drive is available on the CLA class. On the plus side, the ILX should be less expensive to maintain. You might want to take a look at the A3. While the A3 is roughly $6,000 more expensive, it does feel a lot more luxurious on the inside. Although the Honda Civic isn't billed as a luxury car, it does stack up well to the Acura ILX. family should benefit from the Civic's more spacious design and extra fuel savings. On the other hand, some people may not like the Civic's edgy styling. So to wrap up, the 2019 Acura ILX is a standout bargain in the world of luxury cars. Even though it isn't the best performer in the segment, it will keep most drivers entertained during their daily commute. Several valuable safety technologies come with the standard AccuWatch safety package. That's a plus. If styling is high in your list of priorities, then maybe go for the A-Spec trim. While it may take some time to get comfortable with the dual-screen interface, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto will make the smartphone connection a little bit easier.
All right, that's my video for today. Thank you again for watching. And remember, if you haven't already, click that subscribe button. It only takes a couple of seconds, and I really appreciate it. Until next time, I'm Dave Erickson with Everyman Driver. See you next time. Adios.
One more thing before you go. I've added links to some of the best-selling automotive accessories on Amazon right now, along with links to some of my product reviews. You'll find it in the description below this video.